Well, you know, a lot of our younger employees don't have this problem.
Oh.
But I do find that a great many of our not-so-young employees have come here for that very reason. Mm-hmm. So you're not alone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. Leonard was the one that recommended me. I guess he's, you know.
I've got an asterisk next to his name here.
Yeah.
How did you meet Leonard?
Oh, we do Coke together.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Okay. Because he's a great connection for that.
Uh-huh.
And also getting addresses.
Yeah. Well, he's a, yeah. I call him Dirty Leonard. That guy does not give a shit. He's great.
He really doesn't.
Yeah. He helped me with my alimony case, but then, you know.
He helped you with the case.
Well, he helped me get back. Well, I probably shouldn't.
Helped you get back, enough said.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we're very fond of Leonard. And listen, any fiend of Leonard's.
Uh-huh.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, we'd like to put you in the field immediately.
Okay.
We'd like you to camp out in front of Jenny McCarthy's house.
Okay. Cool. Now, what do you want? I mean, do you want to see, like, nudes, or what do you want to...
I want to see everything you can get.
Okay.
You'll have 36 hours,
mm-hmm.
and then you'll have to report back here and just present whatever you're able to find.
Do you want the paperwork that says I'm a sociopath? Does that get me... can I bump up the rate?
Oh, we've got it.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Sweet, man.
Please, we do a little research.
Yeah, because I don't...
I know it doesn't seem like we do research, but we do.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Good.
In fact, these are pluses.
I would hope so.
Yeah. I mean, I understand that's why you wanted to play.
I finally found a field where I can thrive being me.
Yeah, exactly. You
know? Yeah.
Well, I think it's a great outlet. I think it works for everyone. You get to work shit out.
Yeah.
We get great photos.
Yeah.
But I didn't see a lot of experience with a camera.
No, that's true.
You said something about freehand drawing. So you plan to draw pictures of these people? Of Jenny in her home?
Well, caricatures.
Uh-huh. And by that, you don't mean stick figures, because we had a guy that did stick figures and that.
I mean, like, the kind of thing you'd get at a boardwalk or amusement park. Yeah.
So, like, happy, even if
it's
not.
Yeah, like a giant head on a small body in a car.
You know, I've never done that.
Holding a tennis racket, all her interests. What I'll do for, like, Jenny McCarthy, I'll get her with a giant head and a small body in a bikini in a pool doing, you know, like, all these, like, sexting herself and throwing vaccines in the garbage and...
Can you start today?
Absolutely.
Okay, great. Well, that went well.
That was good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That guy just got hired.
Of course.
Instantly. Okay, now let's try another one. I'm a network executive, mm-hmm. and I need you to pitch me Hogan's Heroes. Go.
Okay. All right. You know how funny everybody thinks the Nazis are?
Nope. What do you mean?
Well, they're...
Funny ha-ha? Funny?
Well, it's like...
peculiar?
I would say funny ha-ha because it's sort of like so extreme. I don't know if you remember the Eddie Murphy Buckwheat has been shot.
Yes.
Remember, they just kept repeating it, and after a while, it got annoying, and it was so... But the overabundance made it funny.
Okay, so
that's
their,
kind of like...
Their abundance of effort makes them funny.
It's just so extreme, it's like you can't help but laugh.
At some point, it gets dark and funny.
Yeah.
Sure, okay.
I want to put a sitcom in that world.
In which world?
The world of the Nazis, the world that specifically... prisoners that the Nazis are keeping
at the camps.
Mm-hmm.
So the show takes place at a camp.
Yes.
Huh.
Yeah. Everybody who doesn't like to camp.
Well,
you know,
let's start there. Are they camping or are they in a camp?
I mean, it says it in the name, doesn't it?
Hogan's
Heroes.
They're
in a camp. They're in a camp. Oh no, that
I got the advanced sheet. It said the show is called Hogan's Heroes.
Yes, it's called Hogan's Heroes.
Okay. And
it was going to be called Hoagie's Heroes originally. I wanted to do a show about a deli.
Right.
But that was taken. So then I did some research and I just switched it over.
To a camp.
Yeah.
And
so it's sort of a workplace comedy, but instead of a deli, it's guys trying to get out of a Nazi prisoner of war camp.
Prisoner of war camp.
Yeah.
So they're not all Jews, though.
I don't think there's a Jew in the bunch. There's a little French guy that
sure.
I have in mind.
Well, the French Underground was huge.
Yeah.
Will that be part of the show, the French Underground?
Not too much. I mean, just a little bit.
Okay.
Just a little bit.
Okay.
And I got this guy that I have, this star, man, this guy that I want to play, Colonel Hogan.
Yeah.
He is incredible.
In what way is he incredible?
He's just a fun guy.
He's charming.
Loves to party.
Loves to party.
Bit of a ladies' man.
Oh, okay, that's great. That's helpful for us at the network.
Yep.
Now, you said something about the Nazis being funny. So, are they funny in the show?
They are funny.
Because I don't.
They're like cartoons. They're just sort of like ridiculous, you know.
Over the top.
They're over the top.
A little art.
There's a fat one and a skinny one.
Okay.
The skinny one is bald.
Good combination.
He's got a monocle. When he gets really upset, he opens his eyes wide and the monocle falls. I mean,
that's going to get
this is classic.
Every time.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're talking about a three camera in front of an audience.
No.
No.
No, no, no.
Ah.
I think it's three camera. But there's no audience.
No audience.
It's like a little movie, basically. It's kind of like a weekly The Day the Clown Cried.
Oh.
If you know.
Well.
That movie that was too funny to be released.
Right. But we'd like to show this.
No, yeah, but I'm just saying I'm inspired by that.
Okay, but you're not talking it's going to be too funny or too clownish.
It'll be just
funny.
Are
there clowns in the cast?
There's some cut-ups, but I wouldn't say they're clowns.
Okay.
You know.
Well, there'll be hijinks.
We got this one guy, Richard Dawson, who is...
Richard Dawson, the British.
Yeah.
Guy.
Also a bit of a ladies' man.
Yes.
Yeah.
Certainly if you asked him.
Yeah.
And do they... Does the whole show take place in the camp? Do we leave the camp at any point?
Sometimes they get out.
They get out.
They do get out, but because... Here, let me just explain something. They're not going to have any problem getting out of this camp. So what they do is they dig tunnels.
You mean the prisoners of war?
The prisoners
escape.
Of war. Yeah, because they really are running the place, unbeknownst to these dopey Nazis who think that they're running things.
So they're running the camp? So they're in charge of other prisoners?
Not really. What I mean is that they keep pulling the wool over the eyes of the Nazis.
Oh.
So they'll get out every once in a while to go to a bar to meet up with somebody from the resistance. And things like that. But mostly...
They're coming and going as they please.
Yeah.
Through tunnels, you said?
Tunnels.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
And who built the tunnels?
I mean, probably the Jews.
Okay,
I'm guessing.
Good. Because that's what I had.
Yeah. And that's what you had. In the one sheet?
In the breakdown.
Yeah.
The Jews built the tunnels, but then all the non-Jews are funny in the show.
Yeah.
That's what I had.
By the way, I loved Hogan's Heroes at the time. I never, when I was a kid, I didn't think there was a problem with it.
But I imagine there had to have been a network pitch.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Tell me a little bit about life as a freewheeling kid. Let's spend a little time in the childhood, if you're okay.
Sure.
With that.
Well, you're wearing your San Francisco shirt. I grew up...
Uh-oh. Excuse me while I have some technical difficulties. That's not good. Uh-oh. We lost him. That's not good. Really not good. Wow. Okay. That's gonna be interesting.